Should I play the mortuary assistant? Short answer, yes. Long answer, you wouldn't be blamed for thinking that the mortuary assistant is another run-of-the-mill linear point-and-click horror game with spoopy jump scares, but it's actually a bit more than that. The game has plenty of great jump scares for sure, but it's not those that make this game rather terrifying. One of the things that this game does best is make you uncomfortable. The way it does this is with the whole mechanic of realistically going through the cadaver embalming process. It's creepy as fuck for sure, and really puts you out of your comfort zone by being close up with realistic corpses and having to sew their mouth shut, fill the navel cavities with fluid, and make sure they're moisturized. Honestly, the scariest thing here is that these stiffs have a better skincare routine than I do. Being out of your comfort zone with the embalming process puts you even more on edge, which makes the creepiness and the jump scares even more effective. But what's really surprising about this game is its narrative depth. The backstories of both your character and the head mortician are unexpectedly interesting. Both of these feed into the scenario really well and actually make you want to pursue all the five endings and endure the scream-inducing game to find all the secrets and tidbits of character information. Combine this with a lore consisting of detailed demonology and a warning screen that this game might actually make you more susceptible to a real-life demonic possession. Jesus. This game delivers something a bit more than jumpy, squealy, TikTok-y-worthy content.
I'm gonna look because it's just crazy scary. Yeah, I don't blame you. No.
Hello.
The only downside to this is, just like being a real-life mortician, you do become desensitized to the ew of the embalming process after a while, which means the game does lose its effectiveness over more and more replays. What's stopping me from getting the achievements for embalming 100 bodies and burning 50 is that I'd imagine it to get quite repetitive. Unless, like some people have actually found, you find the embalming process quite soothing if you don't mind the constant interruptions of being the object of a potential possession. Overall, this is a really good horror game, for those of you who are into the genre. If you're squeamish or get freaked out by true-to-life dead bodies, then you might want to steer clear of it. But when I play a horror game that makes me end my stream early because I'm too fucked up and gives me actual nightmares, it's difficult not to recommend this. I give this game 4 out of 5 woofs.